Alright, let's open these up. The pieces of paper they'd folded up lay on the ground next to Jumpy's legs. There were 7 of them, all told. They were written on paper pulled from Jumpy's notebook, and each one bore a code name and a door. Why had they decided to vote that way? They decided it wasn't fair to simply ask everyone at once. That would allow people to force others to go through certain doors. Well, that wasn't the only reason. Jumpy had proposed the voting system, and he had a plan. It wasn't a plan he wanted anyone catching wind of, however, so he did his best to act calm as he began to open and read the pieces of paper. The first one read, Ace requests door 1. Yes, I do. Would you like me to explain why? No, we don't have the time for that, sorry. Let's keep going. He opened the second one. Next the center. He wants door 6. Yeah, that's what I wrote. Jumpy continued with the 3rd, 4th and 5th pieces of paper. Clover wants 1, Lotus wants 2, and 7 also wants 2. Eh? Wait a minute. There's no way I'm going anywhere with the Elephant Man. No. There'd be no point to the voting if we let people change their choices because of stuff like that. But... Just give it up, Lotus. That's not like I want to hang out with some exhibitionist grandma. I'm not an exhibitionist. I'm wearing clothes. Barely. So? Last I checked, that's not a crime. Maybe, but what about common decency? Nobody wants to have to look at a chick who looks like a half-necked raisin. I'm going to kill you! Yeah. Lotus' hair flared out like the mane of an angry lion, and she roared with a voice that shook the walls. With some difficulty, Ace managed to restrain her. Jumpy, read the rest. Right. Jumpy tore his eyes away and looked down at the 6th piece of paper. He opened it. June wants door 6.
Yes. I don't really have a reason, I just felt like it.
All of the papers save Jumpy's had been read. He did some quick calculations in his head. People who requested door 1, Ace and Clover. This was the door on A deck, near the central staircase. People who requested door 2, 7 and Lotus. This was the door on the bottom deck, and could be reached by taking the elevator to the bottom of the ship. People who requested door 6, Santa and June. This was the door on the E deck, and could be reached by taking the elevator near the central staircase down. It took him less than a second to run the numbers. He opened the 7th piece of paper and spoke. Okay, the last one is mine. I want to go through... So, jetzt dürfen wir uns entscheiden, was wir auf den Zettel draufgeschrieben haben. Wo wollen wir durchgehen? Tür 1, Tür 2 oder Tür 6? Wie gesagt, dieser erste Durchgang durch 9 Hours, 9 Persons, 9 Doors stellt ja so ziemlich den Durchgang dar, den ich damals das erste Mal eben gespielt habe. Und bei diesem Durchgang habe ich mich damals für Tür Nummer 1 entschieden. Hatte so ziemlich, ja, es hatte wieder den Grund mit Clover. Ich wollte einfach auf eine gewisse Art und Weise auf sie aufpassen. Ich weiß nicht, das ist so ein komisches Gefühl oder beziehungsweise vielleicht auch dieses, ja, keine Ahnung. Sie tat mir so leid oder beziehungsweise ich wollte einfach wissen, wie es mit ihr so weitergeht, weil das hat mich in dem Moment einfach am meisten interessiert, muss ich so sagen. Auch wenn es sicherlich vielleicht nicht so abwegig wäre, auch durch Tür Nummer 6 gehen zu wollen, damit man eben mit June wieder zusammen ist. Aber trotzdem, irgendwie fand ich Clover interessanter in meinem Durchgang. Und deswegen machen wir das jetzt auch einfach so. Wir entscheiden uns für Tür Nummer 1. My choice is door number one. Santa was unconvinced. Hey, wait a minute there. You're cheating? Cheating? I'm asking if you changed your number after you heard what doors we wanted. How could I do that? I wrote it down on the paper earlier. Let me see that. Jumpy shrugged and handed it to him. Santa examined it furiously. The others peered at it as well. As they did, Jumpy quickly slipped the piece of paper he'd been hiding into his pocket. Although he'd never know it now, Santa had been justified in his suspicions. Jumpy had switched papers. He had prepared three pieces of paper for doors 1, 2 and 6 and put the paper with door 6 on it into the pot. He put a small mark on it so that he would know which one was his. He put the paper that said door 1 in his left hand and the paper that read door 2 in his right. When the drawing began, he saw to it that he drew last. The rest was easy. If he wanted to go into door 1, he'd use his left hand and his right hand if he wanted door 2. Of course, if he wanted door 6, that would be simple. All he need do was switch nothing and say 6 had been what he wanted all along. Well, what does it say? He fought the urge to smirk. Huh, you got lucky. Santa snorted and tossed the paper aside, frustrated. Very well, we've decided who will go through door 1. It will be Clover, Jumpy and myself. 1 plus 4 plus 5 gleich 10, 1 plus 0 gleich 1. Wow, passt sogar. Our only problem is the two remaining teams. June and I want door 6. Lotus and I want door 2.
That's not good. We can't open either of those doors with only two people. Fine. 7, we'll go through door 6.
3 plus 6 plus 7 plus 8 gleich 4, 20. 2 plus 4 gleich 6.
Eine andere Wahl hatten sie jetzt in dem Fall sowieso nicht. Weil es mussten ja alles zusammenbleiben. Also sie fangen wieder mit so einem Quatsch an, wie zum Beispiel einer bleibt zurück, oh mein Gott. Aber das wäre jetzt ja nicht wirklich zielführend, wenn wir davon ausgehen dürfen, dass irgendwann hinter irgendeiner dieser Türen unter Umständen Tür Nummer 9 wartet.
Sure thing. I didn't really wanna go through door 2 anyway. Besides, if we've got a younger girl with us, it'll lower the average rate. the average age. Right, June? June was at a loss for words. Lotus was not.
That pig. You just wait and see.
Her eyes were the eyes of a woman prepared to kill. A shiver ran down Jumpy's spine.
Lotus ist der Killer von allen. Definitiv. Am Ende bringt sie alle um. Aufgrund all der Kommentare, die die anderen gemacht haben. Es läuft darauf hinaus. Zwangsläufig, aber egal.
Even after they separated at the staircase, Lotus was still muttering angrily to herself. Circumstances dictated that Jumpy and June would have to part ways again, but this time it didn't sting quite so much. After all, he knew he would see her again.
Till we find that 9 door, Zero ain't gonna split us up. We might get separated for a little while, but we'll see each other again. Otherwise, we can't open door 9. That's how the nonary game works.
Da hat er recht.
Jumpy, Ace and Clover headed toward A-Deck. They took out the Earth Key and opened the door to the left. It opened and they walked through. It was just as Santa and Lotus had said. At the end of the hallway sat a door with a large red 1 upon it. A numbered door. To the left of it, bolted to the wall, was a red. Ace went first and waved his wrist over the scanner panel. Jumpy was next. Finally, listlessly, Clover lifted her arm. She leaned toward the scanner panel. The third asterisk clicked to life, shining brightly. Ace took hold of the lever. He took a deep breath and turned to Jumpy and Clover. Are you ready? Shall I pull it? Yeah, anytime. Clover said nothing. She nodded, little more than a lethargic twitch of the head. Very well then, let's go. 3, 2, 1. Und rein da. The door opened. They stumbled into the room. Frantically, Jumpy scanned the room. His eyes stopped on the device that would determine whether they lived or died. There it is! Over there! Next to the door they'd come next to the door they'd come through was a dead. As one, they ran to it. They put their hands over it as if they were fighting for it. Logisch. Wir haben mittlerweile festgestellt, dass Explodieren nicht gerade eine, ja. Explodieren ist keine Lösung. It stopped. Yes, it did. Jumpy could feel his heart pounding against the inside of his ribs. Ace and Clover were breathing hard and fast. It was the third time they'd been through the process, but they had yet to grow accustomed to it. Not that Jumpy wanted to. Und es war gar nicht das dritte Mal, jedenfalls für Ace nicht. Ah doch, ja, natürlich war es für Ace das dritte Mal. Beziehungsweise für Clover war es jetzt schon das vierte Mal, ne? Weil sie ist dann ja auch noch freiwillig durch Tür Nummer 3 gegangen. Also von daher, das, ja, gut, egal. He planned to finish the game before he got a chance to let imminent death become commonplace. Jumpy looked around again, this time more slowly. There was another door, different from the one they'd entered through. He took hold of the knob and easily, gently pulled it open. So, this is a real house? He closed the door again and turned to Ace and Clover. He fixed each in turn with a meaningful stare, then spoke. Ace, you investigate the wheelhouse next door. Very well. Clover, you're in charge of this room. Say something.
Okay, I will.
Alright then, let's get started. Seek a way out. So, und da sind wir jetzt also wieder in einem Adventure-Teil und dürfen uns jetzt also auf der Kommandobrücke, wie sagt man dazu, ja, irgendwie umsehen und dann mal gucken, was wir hier alles so herausfinden werden. Ich glaube, für den Moment werde ich aber mal eine ganz kurze Pause machen und dann zumindest die Videos jetzt rendern, die ich jetzt zusammenbekommen habe. Und das soweit dann schon mal fertig machen, damit ich heute Abend, damit ich das Video heute Abend dann noch tatsächlich freigeben kann. Und dann habe ich auch schon, ich glaube, ein oder zwei Videos für die nächsten beiden Tage. Trotzdem werde ich dann nachher nochmal weitermachen, aber dann habe ich jetzt auch nochmal ein bisschen Zeit und Ruhe irgendwie, ja, was zu essen. Denn ich habe Hunger. So, das irgendwie, es macht Hunger, wenn man 3/4 Stunden lang die ganze Zeit Texte vorliest. Egal. So, kam es heute überraschend, was wir alles so herausgefunden haben, beziehungsweise dass Snake tot ist, dass er genauso explodiert ist wie der 9. Mann und dass zwangsläufig entweder Zero mit uns auf dem Schiff herumläuft, dass Zero einer von uns ist oder dass mindestens 2 Leute aus unserer Gruppe Mörder sind. Irgendwie ein beklemmendes Gefühl, oder? Es ist schwierig, da noch irgendwie sagen zu können, dass irgendjemand... Ja, dass man irgendjemandem noch hundertprozentig vertrauen kann. Es ist irgendwie, naja. Mal gucken, worauf das Ganze noch so hinauslaufen wird. Ich freue mich jedenfalls wieder auf eure Kommentare. Und für den Moment soll es dann einfach mal gewesen sein. Ich war der Herringway, das war 9 Hours, 9 Persons, 9 Doors. Ich sag für den Moment dann erstmal Tschö mit Ö und hoffentlich bis ganz, ganz bald.